everyone, welcome to Yes English. I am glad to meet you all through this video. Today we are going to see the poem Once Upon a Time, written by Gabriel O'Hara, a Nigerian poet. Without taking much of your time, I want to give the political background of the poem. Gabriel O'Hara was born in Nigeria in 1921. His country was colonized by British, but Nigerians got independence in 1962. After independence, the country was influenced by Western culture, the British culture. So Gabriel O'Hara feels that before this independence, people were with love and affection, but after independence, they lacked love. So according to him, the people of the past were better than the people of the present. So past is better than the present, so he wants to relive the past. And moreover, he says that his life also has been changed due to the influence of the British culture in the society. And he says the traditional Nigeria with the civilization was badly damaged by the influence of the British culture. He presented this theme in his poem. Before we get into the poem, let's see the introduction of the poet Gabriel O'Hara.
Gabriel O'Hara was born in 1921 in Nigeria. He was educated at Government College, Umahia. His parents were not rich. He worked as a bookbinder and later as an information officer at Enugu. His notable works are The Fisherman's Invocation in 1978 and two books for children, Little Snake and Little Frog in 1981 and An Adventure to Zuzu Island in 1992. His poems appear regularly in Black Orpheus. He also written a novel called The Voice, which was an outstanding linguistic experiment. That was his first novel. He was honored with the Commonwealth Poetry Award. The Call of the River Nun won the Best Award for Literature in the Nigerian Festival of Arts in 1953. O'Hara's typical poem transits from everyday reality to moments of delight and moves back to reality, making a complete circle. In his poem Once Upon a Time, he speaks about the insincerity of relationships and manners prevailing in the present day world. The past, according to the poet, is better than the present. Hence, the poet wants to relive the past.
We are going to get into the poem, The Once Upon a Time. As a pre-talk to this poem, I want to share my feelings with you. Once upon a time, we used to visit our native place. There we met our friends and relatives. We had a nice chat with them. Sometimes we visited our neighbors and there we shared our sweet memories with the sweet, delicious dishes and sometimes with the meals, isn't it? Sometimes we went out with our friends and spent a lot without any calculations at heart. Am I right? But this kind of attitude is not seen with the people now. What I say is true, isn't it or not? The same feeling is seen with Gabriel O'Hara, and he presented the same theme in this poem, Once Upon a Time. In this poem, he compares how the people of the past and how the people of the present. What I said, that attitude is not seen with the present society, the same thing is said by Gabriel O'Hara in his poem. Shall we see the poem, what he says there?
This poem consists of 7 stanzas. This poem is a conversation between a father and his son. The father says to his son how the people of the past reacted and responded. Now we are going to see the first stanza. There are 6 lines in the first stanza. Let me read out the first 3 lines of the first stanza. Once upon a time, son, they used to laugh with their hearts and laugh with their eyes. Here the poet tells his son that in the olden days, people used to laugh with their hearts. When they laugh, they would do it wholeheartedly and with warmth. They used to laugh with their emotions. They would laugh with their eyes and show pleasure with them. Laugh with their hearts means they laugh wholeheartedly with joy and pleasure. The next 3 lines of the first stanza. But now they only laugh with their teeth, while their ice block cold eyes search behind my shadow. Here the poet says, the people of the present love without any emotions. Love with their teeth means it's a fake love. They watch you with their eyes which lack a feeling of warmth. Ice block cold eyes indicates lack of emotions or feelings in their look. The people are hypocritical and they don't mean what they say. Search behind my shadow means they are fake, they are false, they are unreal, and they are not how they appear. Here the poet compares the behavior of the people of the past and the people of the present in the first stanza. Now we move to the second stanza. The first three lines of the second stanza here. There was a time indeed, they used to shake hands with their hearts, but that's gone, son. The poet further tells us the characteristics of the people of the past. The people of the past shook their hands with pleasure and with warmth and do it willingly and wholeheartedly. He tells his son that those habits have gone unfortunately now. Shall we move to the next three lines of the second stanza? Now they shake hands without hearts, while their left hands search my empty pockets. Nowadays, people greet each other without any warmth in their handshake. When they shake with their right hands with him, their left hands will search his empty pockets. Search my empty pockets means that they are evaluating the poet's worth and power or calculating how he could be exploited. So it shows that the people's friendship and intimacy is all for selfish motives or for money. So in the second stanza, the poet compares the characteristics of the people of the past and the people of the present. Out of six lines of the third stanza, four lines are given here. Feel at home, come again, they say. And when I come again and feel at home once, twice. Here the poet tells that people will repeatedly invite you to come again to their home and say that you can feel as if you are at your home. But in real sense, they don't expect you to accept their invitations. You can go there once or twice. Sometimes you will be treated well too, but not more than that. You cannot go after that and you will not be given that kind of hostage. Here are the last two lines of the third stanza. There will be no thrice, for then I find doors shut on me. When you visit your friends and relatives for dinner one or two times, you are the most welcome guest. You are treated well also. But if you go for the third time, they will not allow you in first of all. You will find that their doors are closed. They'll think that you are a nuisance and don't want to see you anymore. Particularly, if you are a frequent visitor, the doors will be closed. Later, you'll understand that their invitations are without any sincerity. So, in this stanza, the poet speaks about the strange behavior of the people of the present. Now we are going to get into the fourth stanza. The fourth stanza also carries six lines. In these six lines, the poet says how he too changed like others according to the situation. Let me read out the first three lines of the fourth stanza. So I have learned many things, son. I have learned to wear many faces like dresses. The poet further says to his son that he has learned many things from others. He has learned to act or behave to the need of the situation like others. Wear many faces means changing the facial expressions. The changing of face is like the changing of dresses. The poet also learned to behave like this. He learned to do so according to the situation like others. Here the poet says, what are the faces he wears like others? Home face, office face, street face, horse face. When he is at home, he wears one face. He is very kind and affectionate. When he is in the office, he wears another face. When he meets someone or when he speaks with someone who is also with one face, he is flexible or rigid. When he comes home, on the way, if he meets someone, he wears another face. He wears a friendly face. There he speaks with the person very friendly. When he invites someone, he wears a host face. He invites the guest, treats the guest well, and sends the guest very happily. So the poet says in this line, he too learned to wear these many faces like others. Here are the last two lines of the fourth stanza. Cocktail face with all their conforming smiles like a fixed portrait smile. Here the poet says how he wears a face with mixed feelings but with one fixed artificial smile. When he acts with mixed emotions like home face, office face, street face, host face, he has to put on a cocktail mask. He has to put on a cocktail face. Cocktail face means a face showing mixed emotions. He cannot show this to all the people all the times. So he has to wear a standard, deceitful, artificial smile on all occasions. A fixed portrait smile means a smile in a fixed picture or a painting. So the poet learns to wear a fixed smile even though he has got mixed emotions. We have come to the fifth stanza. The first three lines of the fifth stanza are given here. Let me read out the lines. And I have learned to laugh with only my teeth and shake hands without my heart. Here the poet says, his life has been influenced by the way the society has changed. He has also learned to laugh with only his teeth, which means in a fake manner, without any emotion. He learned to shake hands with others without wholeheartedness. Now we are going to get into the fourth stanza. The fourth stanza also carries six lines. In these six lines, the poet says how he too changed like others according to the situation. Let me read out the first three lines of the fourth stanza. So I have learned many things, son. I have learned to wear many faces like dresses. The poet father says to his son that he has learned many things from others. He has learned to act or behave to the need of the situation like others. Wear many faces means changing the facial expressions. The changing of face is like the changing of dresses. The poet also learned to behave like this. He learned to do so according to the situation like others. The next two lines of the fifth stanza say how the poet learned to behave differently when an unwanted person comes to his place. I have also learned to say goodbye when I mean good riddance. Here the poet says that he has learned to say goodbye when he actually wants to say good riddance. Goodbye means saying good wishes. Good riddance means a feeling of relief when an unwanted person leaves a place. So he too changed a lot according to the changes in the society. Now we see the last three lines of the fifth stanza. To say glad to meet you without being glad and to say it's been nice talking to you after being bored. Here the poet says that he has learned to say glad to meet you without being glad. He also has learned to say it has been nice talking to you after being bored with his talks. So he has learned to keep his real character a secret and shows the world a fake character. Let me read out the next three lines of the sixth stanza. But believe me, son, I want to be what I used to be when I was like you. I want to unlearn all these muting things. The poet wants to be how he was at his younger days. He was honest and genuine person. Once again, he wants to live as he was in the past. He requests his son to believe this. He wants to get rid of those things that mute means hide his real emotions and return to a more natural way of living. He doesn't like to behave without real love and emotions or hide his real feeling and character. Let me read out the next three lines of the sixth stanza. But believe me, son, I want to be what I used to be when I was like you. I want to unlearn all these muting things. The poet wants to be how he was at his younger days. He was honest and genuine person. Once again, he wants to live as he was in the past. He requests his son to believe this. He wants to get rid of those things that mute means hide his real emotions and return to a more natural way of living. He doesn't like to behave without real love and emotions or hide his real feeling and character. The last three lines of the sixth stanza. Most of all, I want to relearn how to laugh, for my laugh in the mirror shows only my teeth like a snake's bare fangs. Here the poet wants to learn once again how to laugh truly and wholeheartedly, because at present he has a fake laugh. His laugh in the mirror shows only his teeth that are like the poisonous teeth of a snake. It means he is clever and cunning at heart but good at appearance. So now he feels that he is deeply unhappy with his fake personality. So he wants to change this artificial character and acquire a real character with real emotions. The last stanza, the seventh stanza, consists of only four lines. Let's see the four lines. So show me, son, how to laugh. Show me how I used to laugh and smile once upon a time when I was like you. The poet asks his son to teach him or to show him how to love sincerely and genuinely. Why he asks his son is, children are innocent, they are not fake. They don't behave unreal. They show what they feel inside. In the last few lines, he says painfully that he himself becomes a victim of the present scenario. The repetition of once upon a time expresses the fact that the poet wants to be what he used to be in the past. We too feel the same in our society at present, which needs a change to get the real love and warmth. So let's try to change our character to have a natural way of living.